fed by God's word in the Holy Scriptures, and by Jesus' body and blood in the Holy Eucharist, we extend a special welcome to any visitors who have joined us for our celebration. We respectfully ask that you please place your cell phone on silent during this time of prayer. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Lent. The scripture readings for today's Mass can be found on page 73 of the Missalette. Today's second collection is for Catholic relief services. Thank you for your continued generosity. As we gather for Mass, please join me in praying our parish prayer, found on page 5 of your bulletin. Let us pray. Soul of Jesus, sanctify me. Body of Jesus, save me. Blood of Jesus, fill me. Water from Jesus' side, wash me. Passion of Jesus, strengthen me. Within your holy wounds, shelter me. To the service of my neighbor, draw me. To become and grow into Christian, transform me. Holy Spirit, guide me. At the moment of my death, call me, that we as a church parish may praise you with your angels and saints forever and ever. Amen. Please stand as we welcome our celebrant, Father Jude Helfman.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with your Father. Lord, have mercy.
O Word, reconcile the human race to yourself in a wonderful way. Granted, we pray that with prompt devotion and eager faith, the Christian people may hasten toward the solemn celebrations to come. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. In those days, all the princes of Judah, the priests, and the people added infidelity to infidelity, practicing all the abominations of the nations and polluting the Lord's temple, which he had consecrated in Jerusalem. Early and often did the Lord, the God of their fathers, send his messengers to them, for he had compassion on his people and his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of God, despised his warnings, and scoffed at his prophets, until the anger of the Lord against his people was so inflamed that there was no remedy. Their enemies burnt the house of God, tore down the walls of Jerusalem, set all the palaces on fire, and destroyed all its precious objects. Those who escaped the sword were carried captive to Babylon, where they became servants of the king of the Chaldeans and his sons, and the kingdom of the Persians came to power. All this was to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah. Until the land has retrieved its lost Sabbath, during all the time it lies waste, it shall have rest, while 70 years are fulfilled. In the first year of Cyrus, the king of Persia, in order to fulfill the word of the Lord spoken by Jeremiah, the Lord inspired King Cyrus of Persia to issue this proclamation throughout his kingdom, both by word of mouth and in writing. Thus says the king of Persia, thus says Cyrus, the king of Persia, all the kingdoms of the earth the Lord, the God of heaven, has given to me, and he has also charged me to build him a house in Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Whoever, therefore, among you belongs to any part of his people, let him go up, and may his God be with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly
there was this elderly lady who lived here in Lafayette who loved putting together jigsaw puzzles. And so, the day after Christmas, she received a new puzzle. And so excitedly, she opened the box, poured all of the pieces on the table, and then began to study the box and study the pieces. And for hours, she looked at the box and she looked at the pieces, and she couldn't get two pieces of the puzzle to fit together. So finally, in desperation, she calls a young lady who lives next door, and she said, "Sweetie, can you come help me?" She said, "I've been working on this puzzle for hours, and I can't even get two pieces to fit together." She said, "Yeah, I'll be right over." So she comes over, and she looks at the pieces of the puzzle on the table, and she looks at the old lady, and she says, "What is this supposed to be?" And excitedly, the old lady says, "It's supposed to be a tiger," and shows her the box. And she looks at the box, and then she looks at the pieces, and she says, "I tell you what." She said, "Let's have a cup of coffee. And then after that, we're going to put the frosted flakes back in the box." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. What task that was entrusted with Christian preachers during the early years of the church was to explain to prospective Jewish converts how the Old Testament pointed to Jesus. And one way that they did this was to show how key Old Testament persons and events pointed to key New Testament persons and events. For example, they showed how Abraham's son, Isaac, pointed to Jesus. Isaac was an only son. So was Jesus. Isaac was deeply loved. So was Jesus. Isaac was given for sacrifice. So was Jesus. Isaac was to be offered on a hill. So was Jesus. And Isaac carried the sacrifice wood. So did Jesus. Paul makes a similar comparison between the Old Testament and the New Testament. For example, in his first letter to the church in Corinth, Paul compares Adam to Jesus. Paul writes this: "The first man, Adam, was created a living being, but the last Adam, Jesus, is the life-giving spirit. The first Adam, made of earth, came from the earth. But the second Adam, Jesus, came from heaven. Those who belong to the earth are like the ones made of the earth. But those who are of heaven model their lives on the one who came from heaven. Just as we wear the likeness of the man made of earth, so we must wear the likeness of the man from heaven." My brothers and sisters, today's gospel shows us Jesus drawing another parallel between the Old Testament and the New Testament. He says this: "As Moses lifted up the bronze snake on a pole in the desert, in the same way the Son of Man must be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. Now, the Old Testament event that Jesus has in mind, of course, is the one described in the book of Numbers. It's where the Israelites are complaining bitterly to God and to Moses about all the troubles they're having during their exodus in the desert. They're tired. They're hungry. We're walking too long. Any parent who's traveled with a small child has heard this 100 times before. Are we there yet? Are we there yet? Are we there yet? And so, following their complaint, snakes appear and attack the people. And when this happens, the people cry out to Moses, "We have sinned when we spoke against the Lord and against you. Now pray to the Lord to take these snakes away." And so what happens? Moses prays for the people. And then the Lord told Moses to make a metal snake and put it on a pole so that anyone who was bitten, when they look upon it, would be healed. And so Moses made a bronze snake, put it on a pole, and anyone who had been bitten would look at the bronze snake and they would immediately be healed. You know, it's not by chance that the medical profession chose the image of the snake coiled about a pole as the symbol of its healing profession. Jesus parallels the Old Testament event to his crucifixion on Calvary. He explains that anyone who looks upon him with faith will be healed spiritually, just as the Israelites were healed when they looked upon that coiled snake in the desert. But then he goes on. And in our gospel passage, Jesus says these words. It's found in John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not die, but may have eternal life." And then verse 17 reads, "For God did not send his Son into the world to be its judge, but to be its Savior." These two verses in the third chapter of John's Gospel has been called a summary of the Bible. And indeed it is. Listen to the words again. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not die, but may have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to be its judge, but to be its Savior." You know, a number of years ago, these two verses from Scripture, John 3:16 and John 3:17, took on extra special meaning for many Bible readers. Some of you who are old enough to remember know that it had to do with the astronaut program in this country. You see, space engineers were designing spacesuits for the command module pilot and for the lunar module pilot. A part of the design of each of the spacesuits was an umbilical cord consisting of a long, flexible tube. The purpose of the umbilical cord was to supply oxygen to the astronauts as as they walked in space, or passed from one module to another. The suit receptacle into which the command pilot port fit was called J-316. And the suit receptacle into which the lunar pilot's port fit was called J-317. You see, the designer, Frank Dinman, said in an interview that he named the two suit receptacles after these two gospel passages, John 3:16 and John 3:17. He said that his reasoning for doing this was because just as J-316 and J-317 supply the astronauts with what they need to survive in their journey from one module to another, so John 3:16 and John 3:17 supply us with what we need in our journey from earth to heaven. My brothers and sisters, today's gospel is a rich one. It contains first a beautiful summary of the entire Bible. It also contains a beautiful illustration of how the Old Testament and New Testament fit together. But most importantly, it illustrates how Jesus is our lifeline as we pass from earth to heaven. Just as the umbilical cord is the astronaut's lifeline as they pass from one space capsule to another. In other words, just as the umbilical cord supplied the astronauts with life-giving oxygen, so Jesus supplies us with life-giving grace. I'd like to close this morning by recalling the words of Paul in today's second reading, because I think they make a fitting climax to what we've been saying. Paul tells us this: "It is by God's grace that you have been saved. In our union with Christ Jesus, He raised us up in Him to rule with Him in the heavenly world. It is by God's grace that you have been saved through faith. It is not the result of your own efforts, but a gift of Almighty God. For God has made us what we are." May our God be blessed.
Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God.
Father, Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all
sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, and now sits at the right hand of God, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
For our Pope, Bishop, Pastor, Deacons, and members of our parish staff, that they may radiate to those that they serve the tremendous joy that comes from serving God. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the leaders of nations, that they give true joy to their people through their efforts to promote justice and peace for all. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the people of our Catholic faith community here at Holy Cross, that we prepare for Easter with joyful expectation of celebrating the eternal victory of Jesus over sin and death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who care for the ill and dying, that their ministry be filled with the joy of serving Christ our Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, that they may rest in Jesus' peace in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us now present our personal petitions to Jesus in the silence of our heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord our God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who believe in Christ, and grant you a place in the kingdom. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to change my life, but only say the word, and my soul will die. Thank you.
going to sing another communion song.
Our next Holy Cross Silent Eucharistic Adoration is scheduled for Thursday, March 18th, beginning at 12 noon in church. All are invited to spend an hour of prayer and fasting with our Lord at lunchtime. Please join us here in church each Friday during Lent for the Way of the Cross at 5:30 p.m. After the Friday Way of the Cross, head over to the Casey Hall to pick up your Catfish dinners. They are being served as drive-through only this year between 5 and 7 p.m. or until sold out. Meals are $9 each. The Easter flower donation opportunity deadline is Monday, March 29th. You may donate toward our flower decor in memory of, in honor of, or in thanksgiving for a loved one. Forms are at the church entrances. Registration for the 2021-2022 school year at Holy Cross Preschool Little Shepherds is now open. We care for children aged 18 months to pre-K 4. Contact us for more details through our parish website. This weekend, Holy Cross welcomes the NET team to our parish. Please pray for all youth and team members that are attending this weekend's NET Ministries Retreats in grades 6 through 12. Our upcoming Holy Cross Men's Acts Retreat dates are April 15th through 18th. Registration forms can be found online through our Holy Cross website and at the church entrances. Only a few spots are left at this time. Father Mario is helping this weekend with our Women's Acts Retreat. Please keep the team and the retreatants in your prayers. For more information, please see the bulletin or visit our website.
Let us pray. Always ponder what is worthy and pleasing to your majesty, and love you. those called to you, O Lord, and sustain the weak. Give life by your unfailing light to those who walk in the shadow of death, and bring those rescued by your mercy from every evil to reach the highest good. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, we glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And you now, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
He is.